I remember crossing the border at the age of 13. Despite having my passport and visa, I prayed and feared as we passed the border patrol checkpoint in San Clemente. Some years later, I crossed the border again, but this time without my family. I stayed here after my visa expired and became illegal or undocumented. I remember living in fear of deportation all the time, being afraid of going to public places. Every time I saw a police officer, I would run away. I hated my life so much, and at the age of 16, I dropped out of school and left to Mexico. Unable to go to college there and work for a living, I had to come back to the United States. This second border crossing experience was terrifying. I was about 18 years old, and I was detained and taken into a room by three Border Patrol agents. I had lied about my citizenship, and they threatened to do anything they wanted to do with me. Luckily, they let me go, unharmed, but this experience scarred me forever. Today, every time I cross the border, I experience fear and panic. I have earned a master's degree now, and I will soon be completing my doctorate. I have certainly come a long way from those days, and I believe my story represents what has made this country what it is today. Immigrants like myself have come to work hard and earn an education and become assets to this society. One of the most controversial topics of today is immigration reform. It seems to be a very emotionally charged topic, which emerges from the political propaganda of discrimination. Just the mere word immigration brings images of illegal aliens crossing the border in Mexico. Many ignore the number of deaths that have occurred through this journey, and many forget the way our U.S. society has been one made up of immigrants. It seems as though if the U.S. population has suddenly forgotten the history of this country, or perhaps it is precisely this history that is being played out once again. The xenophobia and exploitation of the newcomer. Every so often, a new immigrant group comes and finds itself being the new exploitable minority. We can witness the same rhetoric of discrimination and fear that has been used over the years. The same propaganda manipulated by those in power. It is convenient to ignore the way that immigrants of color have helped build this country, from the hard work of African slaves who were objectified by those in power, to the Chinese who built the railroads and then were forbidden from staying here. Many people ignore that from 1791 to 1952, the U.S. Constitution dictated that to be a citizen of the U.S., a person had to be white. This kept people of color from becoming part of the society and therefore reaping the benefits awarded to whites. Blacks were already excluded through Jim Crow segregation. Over many centuries, the contributions of immigrants resulted in making this United States one of the best economies for many, many years. Yet how much longer can this country claim the title of number one economy? It has also seemed easy to discard the importance of Latinos historically in the United States and to portray them as alien invaders, criminals stealing jobs. Now think of the irony of this. Who can be more alien to these lands? Those with indigenous blood, or whites whose history of colonialism has been one of exploitation and murder? Who can claim the title of criminals when we're looking at our ancestors? They say the history is written by the winners. Perhaps this is why we still have such hateful views on other minorities. Today, many economists and experts advocate for an immigration reform as a way to strengthen our economy. Alan Greenspan believes that if we close our borders and deport the estimated 12 million immigrants, our country would collapse. Today, we must outsource many professional jobs, such as accountants, jobs, and engineers. By educating people who have grown up in this country, we can strengthen the economy and keep jobs at home. Many times, the realities of minorities have been invisible to the rest. The images we get about immigration are skewed and framed by those in power. It is time we look at immigration from the eyes of those who are most affected by it. From the eyes of the child whose parents have been deported and is left abandoned in this country. Through this video essay, I hope to open a window into various images of immigration. I hope to give a voice to those who in this country do not exist.